everyone, it's Anna here from Omar and Hannah, and today I have 10 life hacks for around the barn. I hope these help you as much as they've helped me, but really these guys are the best thing. They help me so much around the barn. So let's get started. I've got 10 of them. So the first one is to put tires around water or feed buckets. These help so much because more me than Omar would go into the stable and say when I'm brushing him or putting a rag on him, I would end up kicking the bucket and it would just spill all over and land on his bed and purina, and I'd have to shovel it all up because it'd be soaking. And putting tires around water or feed buckets stops you, or like even if you do kick it, it stops it from falling over, and it really, really helps, trust me. So putting tires, if you've got them lying about, just put them around feed buckets or water buckets, it'll help you so much. Then the next one I have is baby wipes. So if you go to your horse show and you notice like a dull patch on the horse's coat or a bit of dust on your horse's coat, just take a baby wipe. They're for babies, so they can't be that bad on the horse's skin. Don't do it all the time, but because it might wreck his coat, but just that horse shows at all the time, if you see a dull patch or a bit of your horse's coat that is a bit shiny as the rest, just use the baby wipe and go over it, and trust me, it'll work so much and get it all shiny. The next thing I have is to get a clothes horse for saddle pads. So if you're like me and many other equestrians, we have so many saddle pads, and instead of them lying about the yard and getting dirty and dusty and making the place look a bit messy, you could get a clothes horse and put all the saddle pads on it, and that will help them to not get dusty and it'll make the place look a lot neater. We have that done in our tack room and it works a lot. The next thing I have is to cut a hole in a milk container and use it as a feed scoop. And this here really, really works. If you've got a plastic milk container, just keep the handle and cut a big hole in it, and you could use that for a feed scoop. Just take out a sharp knife, but be careful when doing that, obviously, in case you cut yourself. The next thing I have is having a horse account or a money jar, and this is really, really helpful because horses are very expensive, and even doing activities with your horse like horse jumping or horse shows, whatever you do, can be expensive too. So putting money like once every 2 weeks or once a month or whatever, how long you want to leave it, and just put money into this horse jar or horse account, bank account, or just whatever, it will save you so much. So like when it comes to your horse, like you want to go to a horse show really badly, just take money from that horse account, and you won't be taking a lot of money out of your other account. So just have a account separately aside for your horse. The next thing I have is Vaseline, and this prevents wind chap. Wind chap is when you get a sore upper lip, and it can be cause for riding in the cold. So when you take a thin layer of Vaseline, put it on your upper lip, it acts as a shield and it'll prevent the wind from hurting your other lip and giving you wind chap. This helps so much because I used to get wind chap so bad until I started to do this, and trust me, it works. The next thing I have is to use baler twine for safety knots, and this can be tied up around the yard, and you could clip your horse's lead rope onto it or tie your horse up around the baler twine. And this helps because if your horse ever gets freaked out or tries to pull away, they won't rip your lead rope or damage your head collar. They could break away easily by just pulling the baler twine. We have it all around our yard. It's a lot safer in case your horse does ever freak out. They can get out in a hurry, and it's a lot safer. It's like a safety knot, but better nearly, because it's just that thin, you know, it'll break, but it will still has strength so your horse can't escape on you, but it's still, it helps the horse get out if it's damaged or if there's like, I don't really know, like something happens and it gets spooked, instead of it hurting itself, it can break away. Then the next thing I have is to use nails as wall hooks, so like hammer nails into a bit of drywall, or don't think that would work, but maybe a bit of wood or something, and then put that up in your barn. It could be so much easier for putting like bridles on, hecklers on, lead ropes on, and it just keeps things out of the way, and it can be used as hooks, and they're really, really helpful. My second last one is to cut a barrel in half and use it for water. This is another very helpful one, and barrels hold a lot of water, so cutting one in half, and you can have one in each field, can carry a lot of water, and it can just really, really help. So just as if you've run out of feed buckets or water buckets, and maybe your water buckets for the field aren't big enough, you can fill a barrel, cut it in half, and use half that barrel for water. It's kind of hard to explain, but like I'm sure you understand, like just use half a barrel for water. And my very last one is to put rugs on a pole. So we've got 3 horses at our yard, and their rugs always get confused, so just like put a pole up, like a spare jumping pole or something, put it up on a spare piece of space, and you can hang your rugs on it, and it's a lot better. It keeps them out of the wind, it helps them to dry out. Say if your horse gets wet in the field someday, it helps the rugs to dry out and air out, and we do that with our rugs. You might have seen it before. really works. So that is my 10 life hacks for the barn. I hope they help you as much as they have helped me. And I will see you all in my next video. Thank you very much for watching. Please make sure to like, comment and subscribe. And I'll see you all soon. Love ya!